and nationality according to the Bible. Because it's high time that y'all wake up and stop believing that you're African Americans and acting like African Americans. All right? Because we kept hearing the man say that that's dead. That's dead. But let me tell you something about the God that we serve, brother. Read.
Matthew chapter 22 and verse 32. I am the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob.
So we serve the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Read.
God is not the God of the dead.
He's what?
He is not the God of the dead.
So everything that you hear coming out this Bible is not from a God of the dead. It's right, not right. From Allah. It's not from white Jesus Christ. It is from the black Messiah. It's right, from right. The black God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's no. Not the God of the dead, but who?
But of the living.
Of the what?
Of the living.
Of the living. All right? You right now, you so-called Negroes are in the congregation of the dead. Give me Proverbs 21:16. All right? Because it's time for y'all to wake up. Y'all think this is living. This is not living. Living in the ghettos. Living in the slums. Waking up and you drunk before 12 p.m. Smoking weed. Selling drugs in our communities. That's not living. We.
Bring it up.
The man that wandereth out of... This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 21 and verse 16. The man that wandereth out of the way of understanding.
So the man that refuses to keep God's commandments, who refuses to hearken to the word of God, he wanders out of the way of understanding. What shall happen to him?
Shall remain.
Shall what?
Shall remain.
Where is this brother and sister going to remain at?
In the congregation of the dead.
You are the walking dead, African Americans. You are Negroes who are drunk. You're selling drugs to our people. You're whoring out our sisters. You are in the congregation of the dead. And we are here to bring you back to life. Give me Proverbs 7 verse 2. All right? Because this is what your Christian pastors won't teach you. This is what Joe Biden will never teach you, so-called Negroes who went out and voted for your oppressor. Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 7 and verse 2.
Read.
Keep my commandments.
Do what?
Keep my commandments.
So you have to start keeping the commandments of God. My brother over there who's breaking the Sabbath day by selling your food and then people coming up and buying. You have to keep the Sabbath day or else you'll remain in the congregation of the dead.
Bring it out.
You are the Israelites. You are the gods of this earth.
And live.
And do what when you keep the commandments?
And live.
Then you will begin to live once you keep the commandments of God. Give me Jeremiah 2 verse 14. Because right now, y'all comfortable. Y'all love oppression. Y'all trust in oppression. Y'all are destroyed. Read.
The book of Jeremiah chapter 2 and verse 14.
Read.
Is Israel a servant?
Is Israel a servant? Are we a servant? Yes, today we are in our captivity. We serve the white man. We serve the Arab man. We serve the Chinese man. But read.
Is he a homeborn slave?
Are you a homeborn slave, Negro? Are you a homeborn slave? I'm an Israelite according to the Bible. I'm not a slave. But you are acting like slaves today.
Bring it up.
Read.
Why is he spoiled?
Why are you spoiled, black man, black woman? Colossians 2 and 8. What has spoiled you? What has got you to this lower state? Where slave come from? You are a slave from black folks.
Read. This is the book of Colossians, chapter 2 and verse 8.
Read.
Beware lest any man spoil you.
So Paul is instructing us to beware. Take heed, unless you be spoiled by what?
Through philosophy.
Through what?
Through philosophy.
Voting is a form of philosophy that was put on you by your oppressor.
Bring it up.
Voting is a philosophy. Christianity, white Jesus, is a philosophy. Islam is a philosophy. Egyptology is a philosophy.
Read. And vain deceit.
And vain deceit. But you out here acting like homeborn slaves. Give me Isaiah 51 verse 20.
Bring it up.
It's time for you black men to wake up. You got big problems in your community. We in the stacks. We downtown where y'all at. We out here. We not even from this area, but we here to help it. We here to restore you, great men. Read.
Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 20.
Read.
Thy sons.
Thy what?
Thy sons.
So you brothers over there at the corner store just shooting dice. Man, I used to shoot dice when I was 10. I'm a grown man now, and I'm out here to wake up my people. Y'all little boys over there.
Teach.
Thy sons have what?
Have fainted.
You have lost conscience. You are out here acting like a slave. You think shooting dice on a Sabbath day is a good day.
It's not. That's what niggas do. Y'all gods. They lied at the head of all the streets. As the officer brought out, y'all at the corners, out in front of the apartments, y'all at the corner stores. All right? That, don't we act like that?
Isn't that what a slave is, a nigga? A person that's ignorant, willfully? All right, man, stop drinking. Drink water. That's good for your body. You're defiling your body.
Bring it out.
Excuse you. You hate yourself, brother. Read that from the top.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at all head of all the streets.
All right, so you got to wake up. All right, wake up.
Read. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 51 and verse 20.
Read.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets.
So y'all out here hanging at the corner store shooting dice. Y'all trying to make money off each other. Pump $10, $20. That's not going to change your communities. And if something go wrong, y'all going to end up fighting one another. End up shooting one another. Over some $20, $50, $100. It ain't worth your brother life. You can get roused up if you want to, bro. But we out here to save your life.
Read. As a wild bull in a net.
As a wild bull in a net. You caught in the trap, Negro. You a slave caught in the trap. You just let life pass you by. You have doubt. You don't know how long you gonna live, but you comfortable with it. That's a slave.
Read. They are full of the fury of the Lord.
God has destroyed you. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 63.
Bring it up.
Actually, go to 65. The nigga was born here in America.
That's right.
You dead. I just proved that according to the Bible.
That's right.
Keep the commandments and live, or you're going to die in your sin, old man. Read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 65.
Read.
And among these nations.
So where we are led captive, where we are led and continue to act like slaves, read.
Shalt thou find no ease.
We won't find no ease here in America.
Read. Neither shall the sole of thy foot have rest.
Our feet won't have rest. We work from sun up to sundown, just like our ancestors did. We got two or three jobs. Some of you men don't even have jobs. You trust in this system. You love poverty. You have the solution to your own demise.
But the Lord shall give thee there a trembling heart.
A trembling heart. You are fearful. And I remember waking up in the hood every day, having doubt of if I'm going to live or make it that day. Don't tell me what I went through, bro. Every day, our brothers and sisters wake up with doubt, not knowing how long they going to live.
Read. And failing of eyes.
And failing of eyes. Why? Because our mothers got to see their sons shot down in the street. Single-parent households. That happens in our community. What are you going to do about it? Nothing. We just gonna wake up every morning, drink your life away, and the solution is right here.
I'm doing better than you.
You are God on this earth, and we are here to help our people.
I'm doing better than you.
You're not doing better than me. You ain't keeping the commandments.
Read. And sorrow of mine.
And sorrow of mine. Depression.
What you got?
Fear. Doubt. I got my brothers. That's all I need. I got the word of God. I got the solutions to any problem that I may face.
Read. And thy life shall hang in doubt before thee.
That's what our black men experience every day.
Bring it up.
Our life hang in doubt. Our women are committing abortions.
Bring it up.
When are you black men gonna stand up and change this community? Shooting dice ain't gonna do it. Sagging your pants ain't gonna do it. The word of God can heal anything and anyone, brother. So if you want the true healing, repent, keep your mouth quiet, and just listen.
Right.
Give me Lamentations 4.
God,
you are an Israelite, brother. Stop acting like a slave, a nigga. If you're gonna act like that, then go somewhere else. Read.
The book of Lamentations, chapter 4, verse 17.
Read.
As for us, Our eyes have yet failed for our vain help.
So as for us, as for you Black Hispanics and Native Americans, your eyes fail for your vain help. You trust in democracy. You trust in voting for the next president. Why are you trusting for the same people that enslaved you? And the Democrats destroyed our people more than the Republicans. Biden, he's the one who passed the criminal justice reform. Three strikes, you out. Putting abortions in the Black and Hispanic communities. But yet, he's now your president. So in a couple months, when all hell break loose on you Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans, it's because you trust in your vain help.
And are watching, we have watched for a nation that could not save us.
No, America is going to solve all the problems in the Black Hispanic communities, especially downtown Cincinnati.
A nation that could not save us.
So voting is not going to save you Negroes. White Jesus is not going to save you.
Bring it out.
You need to wake up and stop trusting in America. It's not gonna save you.
They hunt our steps.
What does the white man do to the Negro?
They hunt our steps.
So they setting up traps for you Negroes. They hunt your steps. They put the drugs in your community. They put the guns in your community. And then they watch you. They gonna see what you gonna do with the drug. They gonna see what you gonna do with the guns. And then they gonna arrest you. And then now you're going down a path of destruction. They hunt your steps.
That we cannot go in our streets.
That you stay inside the house until it's dark time. Why? Because you see the cops patrolling your neighborhoods. The real dope boys in the house sleep right now. Why? Because they have doubt. They have fear. They're slaves. They acting like Negroes. The white man has put fear upon them. They want to sell drugs. They want to destroy the community. And you Negroes who are out here today, y'all know who the real dope boys are, but y'all say don't snitch. Y'all know who destroying the community. Y'all know who killed your fourth cousin or your best friend's cousin, but you say don't snitch.
Bring it up.
Give me Leviticus 19:17. Y'all may hate the word of God, but y'all gonna get it. Whether you hear or forbear.
Teach.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 17.
Read.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
But what shall they do?
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
So we out here to correct you, brothers and sisters. You're walking contrary to the laws of God. You are breaking God's commandments. Stop buying and selling on the Sabbath day. Stop smoking and destroying your body. That's for you, brother and sister. Y'all are the children of Israel. The reason that y'all smoking is because of what your eyes see before you. Because you don't have no hope. Give me Romans 15 and 4. You have no hope, so you see whatever that you think is right in your own eyes. But you are a God, my brother. You are a princess of God, sister.
That's right.
Read.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 15 and verse 4.
Read.
For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning.
So we read this Bible so that we can learn from our mistakes. Because we ourselves were once walking the path that you are walking today. We were drug dealers. We were alcoholics. We were whoremongers, gangbangers. But we started reading the Bible, the Old Testament and the New Testament. It was written for that we, as the Israelites, will learn from the mistakes of our forefathers and foremothers. The Bible is all about our people, not white people. Christ is a black man.
Right.
Solomon, David, Job, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, black people.
That's right.
So we learn from them.
That we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures,
patient and comfort of the scriptures. Not voting, not Christianity, not Islam, not Egyptology, not, I'm good. I'm going to just worry about the aura around me and the hell with the rest of my people. No, it's all about our people that through the comfort of the scriptures, what?
Might have hope.
Where do we get our hope from? If we read the scriptures, we'll have what?
Patience and comfort of the scriptures. Might have hope.
We will have hope. You don't have to hope in this American depressive, destructive system that we live in today. Y'all keep hoping. Your hope is vain. Stop believing in America. Now, the God of patience and consolation grant you to be like-minded one toward another, according to Christ Jesus. So we must be like-minded one towards another. We must believe in the same thing. So what's the solution? Zephaniah 2:1. It was brought out already. And then hold Genesis 49:10. Because we are the Israelites.
That's right.
We can't do it by ourselves. No other nation can do it for us. We have to do it ourselves.
That's right.
Read Zephaniah chapter 2 and verse 1. Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together, O nation not desired. So we must gather together. We must gather together as Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, as the Israelites of the Bible.
Yes.
We must do it together. How? We about to find out. We must be like-minded one towards another. Read. Genesis chapter 49 and verse 10. The scepter shall not depart from Judah. So the rulership, the kingship shall not depart from Judah. Read. Nor a lawgiver from between his feet.
Read.
Until Shiloh come. Until Christ come. The Black Messiah. And guess what's going to happen when the Black Messiah come? So right now we are gathered together. But until who? The Black Messiah. Read. And unto him shall the gathering of the people be. The gathering is to the Black Messiah. Not Allah. Not white Jesus. Y'all Christians out here who go to church on Sunday worshiping your God, your oppressor. It's not to no white Jesus. Jesus loves everybody. The hell he do? Our God, the true God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he hate the white man. He hate the Arab man. He loves you, though. That's why you getting oppressed. That's why you getting punished. Give me Amos 3.
That's dead.
We about to see if it's dead or living. Because if it's dead, I can't prove it. But if it's living, I'm going to prove it to you. That's what your pastor won't do. Read. You are the child of Satan. I ain't going to lie to you. Read.
Amos chapter 3 and verse 1.
Read.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
So the word of God was spoken against you, O children of Israel. You so-called Negroes out here just walking around, just living life, trusting in oppression. Read.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
Read.
Saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth.
You are the only people that the one true God has ever known.
That's right.
God has not known the white man. God has not known the Arab man. But you only has God known.
Read. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
So therefore, God's going to punish you for your sins. For you women that want to wear pants. God is going to punish you for your sins. For you men who just want to sell drugs. God is going to punish you for your sins. God is all about punishment and judgment.
We can two walk together except they be agreeing?
So God will not walk with you except you agree with what he commands you to do. We're going to finish Luke 4:18. All right? Because we out here to heal you people. But sometimes y'all need it rough. Y'all need the truth. Y'all need to stop trusting in your oppressor. Stop smoking. All right? Stop getting drunk.
Read. Luke chapter 4 and verse 18.
Read.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
So as you hear this Bible coming out, raw and uncut, just know that the Spirit of God is upon the man up here in purple and gold. Read.
Because he hath anointed me.
We have been what?
He has anointed me.
We have been anointed to do what?
To preach the gospel.
Hold on, what is this?
To preach the gospel.
So we out here preaching the true gospel.
That's right.
This is the true gospel of the Black Messiah. Read.
To the poor.
To the who?
To the poor.
We are the poor people in spirit and in life.
Bring it out.
Everybody not poor. The white people ain't poor.
That's a down
line. Yeah, prove it. Who the president?
Upstairs.
Who the president? White man. All right, be quiet then. Read.
He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted.
So God has sent the chosen men you see out here to heal the brokenhearted. We are the brokenhearted. We have been downtrodden. We have been destroyed and robbed. We are broken. We
to preach deliverance to the captives.
We are the captives. We are preaching deliverance. Deliver your soul. Deliver your people. We
and recovering of sight to the blind.
Recovering of sight to the blind. Those who are walking in the congregation of the dead, you are blind. These false philosophies, false religions, you're blind. Shooting dice, selling drugs, you're blind. There are far greater promises than $100, $200. We
to set at liberty them that are bruised.
To set at liberty them that are bruised. That's us. We've been bruised. Read.
To preach the acceptable year of the Lord.
The acceptable year of the Lord is when the black Messiah cracks that sky and destroys all nations that oppress us and the sinners of his people.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.